Dear students, let us continue the fourth module with another topic. In this topic, we are going to study the FIFO for the inter-process communication. How we can establish the inter-process communication using the FIFO. So, what is FIFO? FIFO is also a pipe, but it is called named pipe. But it has more attributes or more flexibility than the pipe. It also has some advantages over the pipe. The condition for the pipe is that restriction is that using the pipe only those processes which have the common ancestor can communicate with each other, like client server, parent process and child process can communicate with each other using the pipe. But the FIFO, that condition is removed. Any processes, even if they are not related with each other, they can do the inter-process communication with each other. Now here, what is the prototype to create a FIFO? So, the prototype which is used to create a FIFO is MKFIFO. So integer MKFIFO const char star path name comma mode underscore t mode hash include sys bar stat dot h. So using the MKFIFO we can create a FIFO. It has the two arguments. One is the path name, another is mode. So, on successful creation of the FIFO, it will return 0 or else it will return minus 1. So, here path name is the name of the FIFO file which has been created. And mode is nothing but the read mode, write mode and access permission of for the user. Read permission, write permission or execute permission. Now here there are two uses of the FIFO. FIFO are used by shell command to pass the data from one shell pipeline to another without creating intermediate temporary files. So suppose shell wants to pass the data from one process to another process, so it doesn't have to create a temporary files. Using the FIFO it can pass the data. Next advantage is FIFO are used as a points in client server application to pass data between the client and server, and it has also FIFO has also very important role in the client and server applications. So a client can write the data to the FIFO, server can read the data, or server can write back the data to the FIFO file and client can read the data from the FIFO file. Next is example using FIFOs to duplicate output stream. How FIFO can be used to duplicate output streams without using intermediate file? So FIFO can be used to duplicate an output stream in a series of shell commands. This prevents writing the data to intermediate. Now just see here. We have an input file. From input file, we are sending the data to the program 1. And we can, contents of program 1, I want to be written in program 3 also and program 2 also. How it can be established? How it can be established? Using the FIFO. So let us see the next. Here, in this diagram we can make from the contents of program 1 is gone to program 3 also and program 2 also. But before knowing this one, some basic concept we need to understand. T command, because T command is also used to duplicate the file. Now what is T command? So T command reads the standard input and writes it to both the standard output and one or more files. So whenever we use the T command, it the T commands will take the data from the standard input, like from the keyboard and all those things. Whatever command or contents you type from the keyboard, that it will take, and it will display on the output screen, the standard output, as well as one or more files. So see, it did two things. It is display, it is taking data from the keyboard, it is displaying the data on the standard output, as well as it is also displaying sending the data to one or more files. So two times it is showing the data. For example, let us see here, I have a cat temp.txt, and we are creating a type t disk underscore usage.txt. So here contents of temp.txt is displayed here, and using the t command we are sending the contents of temp.txt to disk underscore usage.txt. So here using the t command, contents of the temp.txt is displayed on standard output, as well also it is also sent to disk underscore usage. So this data is displayed here, contents of temp.txt is displayed here, and if we use the command cat to disk underscore usage.txt, we can also see the same output, whatever we are seeing here. So these are the two advantages we have. Now for example, what we have to do here, contents of program 1 need to be sent to program 3 also and program 2 without creating any temporary files. We have to duplicate. So let us see, we will create a FIFO file, that is FIFO 1. So using mkfifo command, mkfifo FIFO 1, and in the background, that contains input of FIFO 1 is sent to program 3. Input of FIFO 1 is sent to program 3, or I can say that program 3 will read the data from the FIFO. Now here you can see that we are creating a FIFO file, and program 3 will read the data from the FIFO. But before that program 3 is reading the data from FIFO, but before that the contents or input of in file is sent to program 1, and using the T command the contents on in file is also sent to FIFO 1 and FIFO 2, as we understood the property of the FIFO. Now just see here, so T command, it is in contents of input file is sent to program 1, and T command is sending the data or contents of program 1 to program 2 also and FIFO file. So program 3 is already reading the data from the FIFO, and T command is sending the data from program 1 to FIFO, and T command is also displaying contents of program 1 to program 2. So this is how, without using any temporary file, we can duplicate the data. So means the contents of program 1 or input file is duplicated. It is sent to program 3 also and program 2 also. So how FIFO can be used in the client server communication? So FIFO can be used to send the data between the client and the server. If we have a data can be sent from the client to server or from server to client. So for example, if we have a server that is contacted by numerous clients, each client can write its request to a well-known FIFO that the server creates. Since there are multiple writers for the FIFO, the request sent by clients to the server need to be less than FIFO buffer. For example,